Welcome to a beautiful day in Los Angeles. A sellout crowd expected at the Staples Center. Kobe Bryant and the Lakers fresh off the victory against the Thunder now face Darren Williams and the gritty Utah Jazz. NBA playoffs continue. The first round is over now that Atlanta, the last one to advance. The Lakers did on Friday night with a thrilling victory in Oklahoma City against the Thunder. Meanwhile, Utah advances with a six-game tough series against the Denver Nuggets, setting up this conference semifinal. Phoenix and San Antonio and the other one that will start tomorrow night in Phoenix. Good afternoon, everyone. Along with Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Green on hand, Doris Burke with us as well. So the Lakers advanced. It was a tough series. It was an exciting series. And so much talked about all the flair with Kobe Bryant and Pau Gasol. But it's defense that's been, really been their go-to throughout the season and in that first round.
Well, surprisingly, you're talking about the Lakers inconsistent on a defensive end throughout the course of the season. Found a way when it mattered most to get it done. You talk about Ron Artest and the job he did individually against Kevin Durant. And then Kobe Bryant adjusting, shutting down Russell Westbrook and his ability to penetrate. The Lakers defense took over, played with a sense of urgency, and was the difference in that first round.
Meanwhile, the Utah Jazz advanced. They're shorthanded without a couple of starters, but they beat Denver. They're certainly the underdog. But when you've got Darren Williams and Carlos Boozer, that 1-2 punch on any given game, you can beat anybody.
Well, you take a look at Darren Williams and Carlos Boozer, they have to be as good in this series as they were against Denver. If not, they have no chance. They're going up against a better defensive team, but Darren Williams still has the ability to put up huge numbers. But the length of the Lakers has bothered the inside players of Utah, particularly Carlos Boozer and Paul Millsap. They've got to figure out how they can score over the length of the Lakers.
Injuries a big part of both teams right now. And with the latest on the Lakers side, let's check in with Doris Burke. Hey, Doris.
Hey, Mike. Well, Lakers center Andrew Bynum has played all season long with what is being termed a very small tear in the cartilage of the front part of that right knee. It was asymptomatic all season long until game six against Oklahoma City, where he hyperextended that right knee. Phil Jackson said he will give him the start. We'll give him an opportunity to see what he can do. Trainer Gary Beattie adjusted the brace on that right knee, attempting to prevent hyperextension. That is the thing that causes Andrew Bynum the most pain. We'll see, Mike, if he can go the full 20 Phil hopes for.
Well, he is in that starting lineup, Doris, in our starting lineups today, presented by Taco Bell. First for the visitors. They win 53 games in the second round with a starting lineup of 3 second rounders and an undrafted rookie free agent. Jerry Sloan's done an unbelievable job. And for the Los Angeles Lakers, as Doris mentioned, Bynum's in. And Ron Artest, speaking of unbelievable jobs, he was superb defensively against Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder. Our Spanish language version of today's game presented by ESPN Deportes. Use the SAP button on your television as we're set to go for game one, best of seven here in the conference semifinals. And you saw those starting lineups for Utah, and that includes Kirill Fasinko, the third-year center out of the Ukraine, starting in place of Mehmet Okur, the all-star who's done for the season with an Achilles injury. Utah also out. The Jazz continue to work on Darren Williams, who hurt himself on the first shot of the game, and they want to make sure he can go out and play, because if Williams is unable to shoot the free throws now, he cannot return to the game. The only time he can return after an injury if it's off a flagrant foul. That clearly wasn't. But Williams appears like he's going to be okay. And just happened 20 seconds into the game on his Friday night as well. Closing seconds. The screen from Chris Anderson. And he injured his left elbow there. Was sore. He got some treatment on that. But that doesn't appear to be a problem. Nor does the injury now. We'll see those. He gets to the line. And look at those numbers. First round against Denver. Sixth in scoring in the playoffs. And first in assists. He was absolutely brilliant against the Denver Nuggets.
And we talked about it. The Lakers had their hands pretty full in the first round against Russell Westbrook. Well, with all due respect, this is a different caliber player. This is the best in the business as far as point guards are concerned and the damage that he can do throughout the series.
We didn't even do justice to those numbers. Those numbers are off the chart type of numbers.
And high shooting percentage as well. He's always been an excellent playoff performer as Fisher's first shot was good. For Darren Williams, the problem is a lot of his playoff games have come against the Lakers and they've ended in losses. This is the third straight year these two teams have met in the postseason. Last year, they got knocked out in five games. 2 years ago, was in the conference semis. Got knocked out in six games, so the Lakers have eliminated them the past 2 years.
And they've already put Ron Artest on Williams after just one possession.
Yeah, Williams looks okay now after the injury. He's got 5 points and the Jazz the early lead. There's Gasol. Gasol's last basket prior to that one was pretty important. The follow in game six against Oklahoma City to clinch that series on a tremendous follow. Wes Matthews knocks down the three. Matthews, one of the terrific stories this year in the entire NBA. The rookie from Marquette. His dad won a couple of championships playing for the Lakers as a part-time player. And Matthews didn't get drafted, but he's a starter and playing very well. And he gets to guard Kobe Bryant down the other end, knocks it away, and comes up with a steal. Everybody on Utah as he throws up a brick. Looking at his hand.
No. Now you shot it. Take credit.
Fisher to Gasol. Gasol left-handed. Can't go. And another tip from Gasol.
You see that size and length of the Lakers, the ability to miss and attack the offensive boards. Not much you can do except keep a body on him before he gets to the rim.
Senko didn't play a lot during the regular season, but now the starter as Boozer's shot off the mark, Bynum the rebound. You hope for Bynum's sake that he's healthy. He's put so much work into coming back from a couple of bad knee injuries. And you like the fact that he's out there starting after hurting it the other night.
I think it would be tougher for him to handle if he was asked to dominate on the offensive end.
Oh, there's a dominant move. And he's limping as he comes up the floor.
And the reason why I say that is because he's in a position where guys will make plays for him. His job is to catch and finish. He's not asked to make plays for himself.
But he clearly was hobbling as he came up the court that time. Boozer, who was their top scorer of the regular season, hits that. But this is a difficult matchup for him, Jeff.
Well, it's the length. But Utah's going to score. They're a great offensive team. But where they have to get better is defensively. It's been too easy early, and they've had trouble guarding these guys the whole year.
And the Lakers get an easy two. Artest, nice move to the bucket. L.A. 5 of 6 from the field to start. Williams. Boozer stripped by Fisher. Fisher with a hand in his face. Off the mark. You mentioned about Utah. They were one of the highest scoring teams during the regular season. Second in the NBA in shooting. As Williams misses that here in the playoffs. They're first in scoring. First in shooting. First in assists. A very efficient offensive team. They're going against a much different defensive team than they did in the first round. Gasol fouled on a pretty pass.
That's an outstanding pass. I mean, I don't know how many guys in the history of the game could make this play. That's a big guy with vision before the catch, realizing that help was on its way. That's a great read.
So you mocked me when I said ridiculously multifaceted last game, but this is. Look at this play. I'm telling you, there's not 10 point guards who can make that play.
Gasol averaged nearly 4 assists a game in the first round. He's always been one of the best passing big men.
And Mike, Mark made this point before the series, and I agreed with it. He said the Lakers should give strong consideration to sitting by him as Gasol makes it, and if necessary, give him a minor surgery in the hopes that he could be back in a couple weeks. for the next round. Not that they would take the Jazz for granted, but they're not winning a championship and beating the likes of a team like Cleveland without a healthy Andrew Bynum.
Yeah, right now he's not healthy. You give him credit for being out there, but he's hobbled. Defensive 3 seconds called against Bynum, so a one-shot technical.
When you say surgery, people think surgery, but, you know, this day and age, you do that arthroscopic surgery, you're back in less than 2 weeks.
Well, just like the Brandon Roy surgery. He had a surgery, and 8 days later, he was back playing. Because if he's not at full strength, I mean, this guy has star potential. He can have big, big-time games, and they're going to need every one of them.
And you look what happened to him against Oklahoma City in game five, the best playoff game of his young career, had the 21-11, was superb. You see double-figure rebounds in four of the first five games, didn't play a lot in game six. Williams, very aggressive, gets inside out to Matthews, another three-pointer. Matthews' shot won't go. There's Kobe Bryant. He had a superb game six. Nails the jumper. All five starters have scored. Bryant had the 32 on Friday night in Oklahoma City. Missed the shot that set up Gasol's winning tip-in. Boozer. The length of Gasol and Bynum will give Boozer a lot of problems. Pacheco, not looking to shoot, gets it off to Boozer.
Boozer got away with a 3 second violation, but if I was the Jazz, I would strongly consider a lot of pick and rolls with Deron Williams. That's their best offense. Pick and rolls with Deron Williams, getting the bigs off the body of him.
And Bryant easily gets to the basket. Lakers 8-for-10 from the field.
But they haven't had a tough shot yet, except for Fisher's contested jump shot that he missed. Everything else has been easy. Utah, as good as they are on offense, sometimes are just as bad on defense.
Boozer misses. They've struggled against the Lakers, not only in the last two playoff series, but they lost 3 of 4. Offensive foul. C.J. Miles, another one of the young guns for the Utah Jazz. Good defense.
That's outstanding defense. The reason why is your job is to send them to the screen. Do not allow Bryant or the offensive guy to go away from the screen. Trust the help. Great job of taking the hit.
E.J. Miles, right from high school to the NBA now in his fifth year, as Bynum will sit down. You look at Miles and Matthews. Got some guys coming off the bench as well. Paul Millsap goes just into the game. You know they're going to battle here for 48 minutes. As you said, Jeff, they need to pick up the defense. Miles started it right there. Foul called on Odom before the shot. Jazz will take it out of bounds. Odom's role will certainly increase if Bynum's injury causes a problem. Odom had his ups and downs in the first round series. Artest chasing Williams, the ball deflected out of bounds. It's going to be Jazz ball, 10 on the clock, and there's Odom's numbers. Did not get in double figures in rebounding at all in the series, and just won some points. Miles for three. Well, Jerry Sloan said against a team with such a height advantage like the Lakers, they're going to have to hit a lot of outside shots. Fisher banks it in. Lakers right now unstoppable. 9-for-11 from the field. Williams to Millsap. Millsap flips it up with a left hand. Nice play.
You think about the team that Kevin O'Connor has assembled. All these undrafted second round picks. I mean, they have done a great job there as Bryant makes another short jump shot of not only drafting the right guys and the right character guys, but then the coaching staff's done a great job in developing these guys.
Matthews drives on Fisher, gets inside, blocked by Gasol. Odom comes up with it. Here's Odom leading the break. Bryant back to Odom, and the finish with a foul. That's beautiful full-court basketball.
That's a pretty fast break. Trusting your teammates. Odom running the fast break like a point guard. Doesn't give it up too early, but gives it up in a situation where Bryant simply has to make a play. Does a great job, but doesn't put the ball on the floor. Touch pass right back to Odom. Stellar job of running the two-on-one fast break.
Odom chance for the three-point play. Bryant, the perfect timing, as you mentioned, Mark. Shannon Brown checks in. Ron Artest will sit. And long rebound goes to Miles. Jazz during the regular season, 21-20 on the road. They improved in the second half. Bad pass from Matthews and a turnover. They're a different team at home. Gasol can't get it. And Brown was out of bounds. Meanwhile, the Lakers here at home, dominant, one of the best home records in the NBA, 34-7. They won all three home games in the first round. Jazz won a game in Denver in that opening round. Gasol reaches in and causes a deflection. Here's Brown, crossover, nice move, lays it in. Couple of terrific fast breaks for the Lakers. They're up by 9. And Jerry Sloan wants timeout. Lakers have hit 12 of their first 14 from the field and getting out in transition as well.
And it's ignited by good defense. Pau Gasol circling the low post to deflect it. Fisher, good advance pass to Shannon Brown, who finishes the play with strength and athleticism.
All new ABC Sunday at 9, 8 Central. The betrayal and the danger have moved back to Wisteria Lane. If you're looking for trouble, you've come to the right neighborhood. ABC's Desperate Housewives. All new Sunday at 9, 8 Central on ABC.
We have a lot of dysfunction on the shows on ABC. Happy Town really isn't happy. Desperate Housewives aren't really desperate. They're like, you know, betrayal. I mean,
dysfunctional prime time on ABC.
How about this show?
Yeah.
Kobe Bryant with a hand in his face. Nails it. And Bryant 4 for 4. The Lakers simply can't miss. They're up 11. They've got 26 points with 3.5 to go. The only way they don't score is if they turn it over. Williams. Boozer on the follow. Holds on with some Lakers underneath him.
But even in situations like that, Williams catching the ball on the move, that penetration got Pau Gasol's body off of Carlos Boozer and allowed him to crash the offensive board.
Williams guarding Bryant now. Kobe Bryant 5 for 5 from the field. The Lakers didn't shoot so well in that first round against Oklahoma City. The Thunder's defense, very good, one of the best in the league. They're having an easy time now. Nice deflection from Fisher. Fisher has at least 2 steals, and he's deflected another. Gets in, knocked away by Boozer. And an easy opportunity for the Jazz. Now Phil Jackson calls timeout. Not happy with the 2-0 Utah run. Kobe Bryant hasn't missed yet. Lakers barely have missed. They're 14 of 16. They've made 9 in a row, Mark.
Making plays, isolation, knockdown, jump shots. The Jazz are thinking, that's not the Bryant we saw in the first round. This Bryant isn't fair. Got it going early.
And Jazz, what a hot start for the Lakers. 14 of 16 from the field. Let's take a look at who's primed to perform, presented by Gatorade. That guy hasn't missed yet.
When you take a look at the way he starts this ball game, got it going offensively. Take a look at the Lakers today, getting it done from the field, off of turnovers, transition opportunities, easy basket plays, pushing the basketball, and it starts with their best player, Bryant. When he's got it going from the outside, you can forget about it. The ability to break down interior of your defense, you're allowing them to play one-on-one, just not fair. If you're the Jazz, you have to find a way to get the ball out of his hands, because when he's got it going this way, as far as a rhythm offensively, you got to force other guys to be aggressive and make plays.
If you haven't been watching the NBA this year and just tuning in the playoffs, it has not been an easy year for Kobe Bryant. He broke his right index finger back on December 11th. He's had right knee problems, left ankle problems. He hasn't been 100%. You don't know. He's even admitted his elevation's not there. He's had some nights where you can clearly see that he's hurting as he's called for a double dribble there. Well, he looked sharp on Friday night in game six. It looks terrific here so far this afternoon.
And I liked Wes Matthews' defense there a lot better. A lot more challenging Bryant versus being back on your heels.
Darren Williams to Millsap. Nice setup. And again, a pretty left hand from Millsap, who had a very good first round series.
Well, it shows you how good Darren Williams is. You put Ron Artest on him, it really doesn't matter, because here's a guy that has the size, the strength, can lull you to sleep, change speeds. So it doesn't matter who you put on him. It's about the help behind that person.
Gasol, a little further outside than he normally shoots. Millsap the rebound. Millsap had a 19-rebound game off the bench in the first round against Denver. He's a terrific rebounder, especially for his size. An undersized power forward. Tough shot from Boozer. He gets the roll. Boozer with 8 points. He's 4 of 6. And Jazz with 6 straight points. Right back to Bryant. Odom to Gasol, the big man with such beautiful passing.
That's just good patience on the offensive end. Bryant not trying to do too much, takes the double team, and then the unselfish play leads to another unselfish play. Odom to Gasol.
And if I'm Utah, I'm not going to double him as much in the post. I'm going to help on the dribble, but not coming on the catch, because the Laker bigs pass the ball too well.
Matthews to Millsap. Millsap lines it up. Shot won't go.
That's a great situation for the Lakers. Love to go 2-for-1.
Williams pumping him. Offensive foul. Nope. James Caper, you know, he signaled the wrong way. He signaled the other way, but he calls it on Darren Williams, and that's the right call. It was clearly not an offensive foul.
See a lot of contact. Very physical play. Bryant had it back. He'd probably heave up a shot on the whistle.
Gasol. Shannon Brown can't get it to go. Costa Koufos tips it, and here comes the Jazz. Jazz want to get some transition going, but it's tough to get on the break when the other team shoots 80% from the field. Shot clock is turned off. Lakers do have a foul to give. Kyle Korver, the three-point marksman, bad pass, the turnover. Williams gets it back, and that will end the first period. Williams shaking up again, diving for that. He can't get a break. The story of that first quarter is the two-point guards hustle. And just trips up down at the end. Terrific hustle from both teams. As we end the first quarter here in game one. Williams getting more treatment. Kobe Bryant getting a rest after going 5 for 5 from the field. Got some help from Pau Gasol as well. As the Lakers in that opening period shoot 79% from the field. Coming off the emotional victory Friday night against Oklahoma City. Lakers back home and looking sharp. First quarter complete here at the Staples Center. And the Lakers lead it by 7. This presentation of the NBA playoffs on ABC continues after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Welcome back to Los Angeles with Jerry Sloan. Obviously, they're off to a terrific start offensively, the Lakers. What's most problematic for your defense?
Well, not only our defense, but every time we take the ball down the floor, we're trying to take shots instead of executing. They've done a great job of knocking us around, pushing us out of where we'd like to be. And consequently, they've won that battle because we started standing around holding the ball. That hurts us on the other end of the floor.
Coach, thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
Mike.
And Doris, as we said, Lakers shooting an incredible 79% from the field. Brown gets inside, blocked. Millsap with the save. Jazz contest that one. Ronnie Price is in. Price, the backup point guard. C.J. Miles, Kyle Korver, Costa Koufos, and Millsap. We go through that, and for a lot of just casual NBA fans, it's a A lot of no-names you haven't heard of. Here they are battling the defending champs in the second round.
I haven't heard them, and I follow the NBA all the time. No, I mean, look at that team they have out there. They have one first-round pick in Miles and Kupas, but they don't have a lot out there.
Bynum misses. Kupas able to defend it. Kupas, the big guy, 7 feet tall, second year out of Ohio State. Doesn't play a heck of a lot, but with the injuries, as he misses that shot, again, no Mehmet Okur and no Kirilenko.
And Jerry Sloan wasn't a huge fan of that early jump shot. I can't repeat what he just told Kupas.
Farmar in the game, kicks it out to Brown. Luke Walton's also in. Walton steps up and hits a three. The Laker bench played very well in game six in Oklahoma City.
That's a great read by Lamar Odom. The previous play, Shannon Brown had the same play to make, ball faked and went to the cup. That time, Lamar Odom catches it, finds Luke Walton all by himself in the corner.
That's their first three-point attempt of the game. They haven't had to shoot threes, so easily getting inside. Millsap misses. Bynum wants the ball. Here's the double. Bynum, nice pass. Trip and a foul. Let's check at least a recent huddle from Phil Jackson.
All right, now this team's a bunch of strippers and hackers out there. You expose the ball, they're going to be on your hands whacking away at it. So you guys got to take care of the basketball. We had too many turnovers.
The Jazz are a very physical team. As Walton goes to the free throw line. Now, with that great start by the Lakers, we're wondering what's the highest field goal percentage ever in a playoff game. Our statistician Dave Freet looked it up, and it was back in April of 1990. The Knicks let the Celtics shoot 67% from the field and score 157 points.
And that was my game plan, by the way. Stu Jackson should have fired me immediately, but I do have an excuse. Mark Jackson was my starting point guard. Our starting point guard. He was getting torched that night. Really wasn't my fault.
Farmar lost it out of bounds, but last touched by Price. You really can't say anything because he was the Big East Defensive Player of the Year when he was at St. John's.
Well, I don't know where that defense went, but that defense dropped.
Give me credit. In spite of not believing the coach's game plan, I still attempted to execute.
Right now, the Lakers executing everything beautifully on the offensive end. They lead by 9. 2.5 gone by in the second. Farmar wanted a pass, gets a good look, and knocks it down. Boy, if the Laker bench started playing consistently, it had not been the case during the regular season. But they had a couple of good games in the first round.
Well, you take a look at this bench. What they're doing is they're executing their offense. They're trusting the system and getting good looks off.
Still Jazz ball. Nope, it's going to be Laker ball. My mistake. No, Mike McCallahan is going to change the call, I think. As you see the Laker bench, Brown in double figures. Again, limited minutes, but they had nice stretches. And now they change the call. So it will be Jazz ball. And they're going to reset the shot clock. Yeah, it looked like a touch Odom last.
Well, you talk about the bench had a great stretch to end the third quarter in game six. But I give Phil Jackson credit because there's no way in the world I would have sat Kobe Bryant that long. He really got away with leaving the best player on the bench.
Shot clock has not reset. That was an air ball. So Ronnie Price jacks one up. Back of the rim won't go. Brown the rebound. Jazz shooting just 42% from the field. And then the Lakers, right now through the first round, the best defensive numbers of any of the 16 teams in the playoffs in terms of opponent field goal percentage. Shot clock at 7. Odom, long three, nails it. They've only taken 2 threes, but both of them gone down, and the lead is 14.
And what they're doing very well is getting Andrew Bynum touches in the paint. He's not scoring, but he's taking the double team and putting guys in position to score.
9 straight points again by the Lakers. Korver, quick catch and shoot. Korver knocks it down and a foul. Odom runs into him. Kyle Korver, one of the best shooters in the NBA, gets on the board. And a much-needed bucket for the Jazz as we have timeout.
Well, I like this. Kyle Korver, very good off screens. And I do like how this is called more in the NBA today. They are protecting the jump shooter. And this is Mark Jackson's outfit. No wonder we got torched. You bring a guy that looks like this into your locker room in a big game, you cannot win.
And there's the Big East Defensive Player of the Year.
Shooting the ball.
Back where they were the St. John's Redmen.
Wow.
Long time ago. Utah Jazz down by 12, still early in the second. Aaron Williams banged up, but Doris Burke reporting that he's okay. Right now, staying on the bench. You go around the league, you get a lot of superlatives talking about Deron Williams. Phil Jackson is a fan of this young point guard.
I can't think of anybody he reminds me of. He just is, you know, has a big body, barrel-chested kid. You know, his body kind of reminds me of Mark Jackson, but, you know, his speed's 10 times greater than Mark's.
Oh, that's an underestimation. That's underestimated. It's not 10 times. It's like 25 times.
What is this, take a shot at Jack Day?
No one really deserves it more. But you think about it. Is he talking about today's Mark Jackson body, or is he talking about playing Mark Jackson body?
I'm faster today. You haven't seen me lately. I'm a two-time champ in the rec league.
This guy gives me his stats from the Calabasas Boys and Girls Club Senior Adult League Championship. And Brian Russell, who used to play for the Jazz, is still celebrating his scoring championship.
Here's
this guy thinks he's like still a player.
We're getting it done. We're finding a way to get it done in spite of age.
Was it hard to go back to back?
Gasol, Jawoko, rebounded by Boozer. Meanwhile, we have Jackson talking about Deron Williams. We just frequently say Deron Williams might be the best point guard in the NBA. He's one of the best players, period, in the NBA. Not just point guard. He's really, as an offensive foul called against Millsap, he's turned into one of the premier players in the league, regardless of position.
Well, with all due respect, Phil Jackson, it was an underestimation because he is certainly far superior as far as quickness. And with the great players, you don't have an answer for him. And he fits in that category because there's no answer for Deron Williams and what he's able to do against you as an opponent.
You think like a guy like Chris Paul is home just seething when he hears that, like the best point guard in basketball?
You know what he's thinking. Y'all must have forgot.
And there you see, Williams now three consecutive seasons with averaging at least 18 and 10.
You know, and you forget about Kevin Johnson in that list. When he was running two-man game with Tom Chambers, pick and roll, that was maybe the hardest one to guard.
Yeah, well, nice move from Luke Walton there. And today, there's so many terrific young point guards in the NBA. Of course, Chris Paul, who you mentioned, Derrick Rose, Rajon Rondo. Then you got the old guys with Nash and Phillips and Jason Kidd. Every night, you're a point guard, boy. It's tough.
And you didn't even mention the guy we just finished watching in Westbrook. And by the way, that's Mayor Kevin Johnson to you, sir.
I know, right? Sacramento mayor. He's got to get that new arena going in Sacramento. The Maloof brothers, the owners of the Kings, need a new arena to stay there.
You're just stumping for everybody. As Miles will go to the free line, puts it in. Let's listen to Deron Williams talk about all the point guards.
It's crazy. You know, there's really not a night off at the point guard position. You know, any night, you know, if you're not facing a good young point guard, you're facing a tough veteran, you know, like Chauncey Billups, Steve Nash, Baron Davis. I mean, guys that are still, I mean, Derek Fisher, you know, guys that are still able to compete at a high level.
You know, I thought about running for mayor, but that pitcher with the pink suit hurt me.
Hold it. How about him slipping in Derek Fisher at the very end? Because he had to play against him, and he played with him in Utah, where he started with Derek Fisher when they made their run to the Western Conference Finals a couple years back.
Gasol flips it up, misses. Miles runs it down. And that was 2007. And that was also the year that Fisher made that unbelievable return to the Jazz in game two of that series against Oklahoma, against Golden State. Gasol with a rebound. Remember, Fisher had, his daughter was going through such a difficult time. She had a form of eye cancer, was undergoing surgery in New York. As Bryant drives and lays it in. Fisher came right from the airport, right to the arena, played in that series. And after that year, the Jazz, in showing the kind of people they are, Larry Miller, the late Larry Miller, released Fisher from his contract so he could sign in L.A., where they felt they were closer to better hospital and doctors for that form of cancer for his daughter. It was such a class move by the Jazz.
You're talking about an all-time great playoff moment when Derek Fisher entered the building.
And then he makes his first shot. And I'll say this, because we lost to the Jazz that year. Derek Fisher, you know, sometimes you release people and they don't have an impact on your team. Derek Fisher that year was a starter and also the backup point guard. He had a huge impact on them going to the Western Conference Finals.
Nice move from Carver, the three-point shooter, with a pretty play off the dribble. And again, you'd think by just watching this game that the Lakers are just manhandling Utah, but it's only nine.
But they are. They're manhandling it. Now, they could fall into a funk and let him back into the game, but the Lakers are showing exactly what they are right now, and that's champions.
Gasol, Pau Gasol, 10 points, 4 rebounds.
This is bad defense by the Jazz, and you can tell, looking at the body language, they have no answers right now of how to stop this high-powered Lakers offense.
Boozer. Still an unbelievable high percentage. Fisher, smart play, just goes right at Korver, who had to backtrack, and he draws the foul. 11-point lead for the Lakers here in the second.
Too many weapons offensively. You talk about Pau Gasol, put yourself in position to catch. Where's the contest? Who's going to keep a body on him? Just too skilled. And then Bryant, one-on-one, no shot block in the paint area, able to get all the way to the cup. That's Matador defense. Olay, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks for watching ESPN on ABC, home of the NBA Finals.
Back in Los Angeles, Lakers with an 11-point lead. Game one of this Western Conference. Baseball continues on ESPN Sunday and Monday. Mets and the Phillies tonight on Sunday Night Baseball, presented by Taco Bell at 8 Eastern. Then the Angels and the Red Sox on Monday Night Baseball, presented by Sears Lawn and Garden at 7 Eastern. Big Mets-Phillies early season battle. They split the first two games.
There's one New York baseball team in first place in their division, Mike.
There you go.
What does that mean?
Let's go Mets.
We're peaking right now, okay? Just let it lie.
This is May 2nd, by the way.
As I said, we've hit our peak.
Derek Fisher with 5 early points. Fisher's starting to shoot well after the first couple of games. And able to get that one to go. Such a seasoned playoff performer. Derek Fisher now in his 14th year, 35 years old. Talk about playing all those point guards. He's got to do it almost every night. Williams back in, Artest in pursuit. Good pass inside. Shot blocked by Odom, then blocked by Gasol. Millsap had 2 good looks, both rejected.
See, that's great offensive execution, but just no length to be able to get up over Pau Gasol.
Bad shot that time for Kobe Bryant. He wanted a foul. He had 2 Jazz players on him. Williams on the drive. Kicks it out. Miles. Miles the runner. Won't go. Odom tips it. And it's Jazz ball.
The Lakers are doing a good job of collapsing to the basket. There again, 5 Lakers in the paint. Collapsing to the level of the ball. Very good defensive pursuit by LA, and that's what Utah is not doing, as Kobe Bryant is oftentimes just walking right to the rim.
Williams steps back, puts up the 3, puts it in. Darren Williams now 13 points, and it's back to 10. He realized he has to score a little bit more now with Okur out and with Kirilenko out, and he certainly did that in the first round. And he averaged almost 26 a game and shot 49% from the field. Offensive foul, Kobe Bryant, his 2nd. This kid Matthews does not back down at all from anyone.
That's a good call.
Williams drives inside, kicks it out. Miles, extra pass, Matthews.
See, I think you have to shoot that shot. To me, that corner 3 was a better shot than C.J. Miles ended up taking.
Lakers have done a good job defending the 3 in the first series and here. Artest double team, kicks it out to Fisher. Fisher with a jump shot, won't go. 10-point game as we're coming up on 3 minutes, and Fisher calls for the block. That's the third team foul against the Lakers, second on Derek Fisher. Crowd not happy with that whistle or the lack of a whistle down the other end.
This is the best situation for the Jazz. Get stops, push the ball, and that's clearly contact. Deron Williams with the ball in his hands, going full steam ahead. That's tough to defend.
3 second violation. That's turnover number 7 for Utah, same as the Lakers. There's Kirilenko. They certainly miss him and what he brings defensively, his intangibles as well. They're hoping that Kirilenko will play maybe game 2. Strained left calf. He missed most of the final month of the regular season, but he's very close to returning.
And I think he would be of more help as a four-man, as a backup four, than he would to come in and play on the perimeter. That's where I think he's at his best and had his best years in Utah.
And great play from Deron Williams as Kobe Bryant went for the fake and picks up his third foul. And Deron Williams, who shot more free throws than anybody so far in the playoffs, will get to shoot 2 more. One of the best young players in the NBA had a spectacular first series, off to a good start here in game 1 of the second round. And Williams already with 13 points, but his team down 10. Lakers strong defense again. They lead by 10. Second quarter of game 2 of this Western Conference semifinal. And the first round's over. All the awards being given out. The last one today, Dwight Howard started with the Defensive Player of the Year. Another one for him, Scotty Brooks. What a great job he did with Oklahoma City. Coach of the Year, Jamal Crawford. And the Hawks now in the second round. He's a big part of what they've done. Aaron Brooks took a big jump this year with the Houston Rockets, most improved. And Tyreek Evans, from start to finish, the Rookie of the Year in the NBA. And LeBron James expected to get his MVP award. It'll be part of halftime. And the T-Mobile Halftime Report coming up. Stuart Scott, Magic Johnson, Michael Wilbon, and John Barry. They'll talk about the Hawks' win in Game 7 and the MVP for LeBron. They'll talk with the MVP, two-time MVP.
And I actually had one, the best supporting actor. I picked this guy, clearly.
Just a minute. Oh, I got it. Ah. It's okay. Ah. No, just hold on.
Oh, the close outtakes.
Hold on.
The door is locked. The door seems to be stuck.
It's jammed.
The door seems to be stuck.
That's a joke. You guys, really, study your stats more. You got better things to do. You know what I was just thinking about, though? You can't have all those NBA awards and not have Kobe Bryant win something. Hey, and on this one, I'm just going to say right now, I was cold. That's cold water. That's cold water.
We'll give you credit. We have to endure during halftime. They play the song Cotton Eye Joe here at Staples Center, and you're here singing during the timeout.
Oh, yeah.
Watching you act, though, I get goosebumps.
You know, and talking about acting, I think Jack Nicholson is overconfident. He's not even here today.
That's a foul away from the ball.
He's taking this round not serious enough. I'm calling him out right now if he's watching.
Well, it's morning in the L.A. Times. Bill Plaschke, the terrific columnist, he said this series is like an intermission. He said that Utah Jazz, it's Deron Williams, Carlos Boozer, and a bunch of guys drawing charges. Well, the Jazz is certainly the huge underdog here, but they'll scrap and fight every step of the way.
Well, I've been in situations where you're playing a playoff series and you're watching your next opponent's battle as Ron Artest with an easy lane. And truthfully, you'll never tell somebody who you would prefer, but it's a fact. The Lakers preferred the Utah Jazz over the Denver Nuggets because the Nuggets' ability to elevate their game and then the individual challenges. It's going to take superior effort from this Jazz team to beat the Lakers in the series.
Boozer upset. He thought he got fouled, and instead he gets hit with a technical. Boozer making a good aggressive drive. But the Lakers converge. He didn't get the whistle. Let Monty McCutcheon know it. And a technical foul.
I would have rather seen them be able to get out on the break and then call the technical later. Here, Boozer drives to his left. Odom is in the restricted zone, but because he started that drive in what's known as the lower defensive box, he can be in that restricted area. And I think that's good, solid defense.
Yep. Fisher misses the technical free throw. Boozer 4 of 8 from the field, 8 points, 4 rebounds.
You can see the Lakers since game 5 and game 6, the first round against Oklahoma, and then already in game 1 here. Big's doing a great job of lifting their hands up without fouling, forcing people to score over their length.
Under 2 to play here in the first half. Ron Artest can't get it to go. Odom takes it away from Millsap. He is such a good rebounder. Nice pass to Saul. The big man with a pretty assist on Artest to finish, and the lead back to 13. Williams with Artest on him. Millsap has an open look, gets it to go. Millsap with 6 points. How about Artest? Last series, he's got to guard Kevin Durant. Now he's on Darren Williams.
We talked about Artest, where he would be graded with the way he played when it mattered most. He certainly has showed up, especially in that first series against Durant.
Williams throws it down and a foul. Wes Matthews started it with the steal at the other end. And Darren Williams able to finish. And again, it's back to 9.
How about Darren Williams? Fast break, Ron Artest. My goodness, you're talking about a point guard cocking it back and punching it like a painter on Artest.
Like a what?
Artest. Painter.
Oh, like, man. Oh.
I can't explain everything to you, man.
I like it. Now I like it. I didn't know what you were saying. Now I like it.
This is what Darren Williams telling us yesterday. He knows it's a tough matchup, but he's very confident every time he steps on the floor that he's the best point guard in the NBA. Artest, a whistle, and a 3-second violation. Offensive 3 seconds. So the turnover for the Lakers, that's 9. Our NBA calendar, TNT tomorrow. San Antonio Phoenix will start off game 1. Boston and Cleveland game 2. Cavs took the first one. And ESPN Friday, those 2 teams or 2 series will continue. ABC Saturday primetime. The Lakers in Utah, game 3 in Utah. Talk about unbelievable environments. We saw it Friday night in Oklahoma City. We'll see it again next Saturday in Salt Lake City. Gasol doubled. And a foul on the pass. Jazz in the penalty, so Gasol will shoot.
So, Coach, I'm sure you can agree with this. One thing you don't want to do, first of all, the Lakers should have a bigger lead. When you fall asleep during the course of a ball game thinking that, oh, it's an easy one, you can develop bad habits. And that's the concern of your Phil Jackson and the Lakers. Continue to play the way you're playing, because bad habits develop in situations like this.
Well, you know one thing, Utah's going to keep playing. They're not going to stop. They're going to keep playing. And the Lakers want to make sure that when you're going up against a guy like Darren Williams, it's not coming down to the last 2-3 minutes of a game, because he can win those type of games by himself.
Gasol hits the first. They're just 4 of 7 from the free throw line. Lakers not shooting free throws well. Lowest shooting free throw team in the first round of the playoffs. Gasol 11 points, 5 boards, couple of block shots. Lead back to 10. This should be the final possession. Some full court pressure. Matthews on the drive. The runner puts it up, puts it in. Pretty move from the rookie out of Marquette. Final seconds, Farmore. That'll count if it goes. That ends the first 2 quarters here in game 1. Kobe Bryant, the Lakers got off to a huge start. Bryant, you see 6 of 7 from the field. Lakers went up by as many as 14. But Darren Williams and the Jazz always fight back. Williams had a terrific first half, continues his hot scoring. Averaged 26 in the first round, has 17 here in the first half. Let's check in with Doris Burke.
Now, it felt like the Lakers were in control that entire half, but they're only down 8. How pleased with what transpired were you?
We started off right. I think we made a good run, but we got to make sure we continue to build on leads. You know, when we get to 10, 15 points, we got to work from there on and not just we get comfortable with the lead.
What pleased you most about your game in that first 24?
We moved the ball pretty well for the most part. It's just hitting the post, cutting. It just makes the game a lot easier. When we do that, we're really effective.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mike.
All right, Doris. Overall, though, they shot so well. 61% from the field in that first half. The T-Mobile halftime report's coming up. Hawks advance to the second round with a Game 7 victory earlier today. The gang will look at that. And then two-time MVP LeBron James. Wasn't unanimous, but he got another MVP. They'll interview the Cavalier. Game 1, best of 7 of the Western Conference semifinals. Familiar foes. Lakers have beaten them each in the last 2 years. Here in the first two quarters, they've got an 8-point lead. Third quarter set to begin at the Staples Center. Game 1, Lakers leading the Jazz 53-45. A Windows 7 winning combination. The big guys up front for L.A.
Talk about that length and size. You beat on dribble penetration. Well, Pau Gasol would help blocking a shot without fouling. And then Millsap defensively overmatched the size of Pau Gasol, so he's forced to foul Gasol. Millsap again, the triple play, one block by Odom. Kobe gets a piece, and then he brings it back down, and Powell says, I'll have another. That size, length, athleticism. And then what the Lakers are doing, contesting without fouling. That's a 7-foot sandwich. Both guys, long hands, not allowing the Jazz to get to the free throw line.
And despite a lot of that dominance, Jeff, how is Utah still only down by 8?
I truly have no idea. And I just don't know. I think it shows their resilience. When looking like they've just been beaten, haven't really defended well, and here they are getting a stop right out, and, you know, they're just hanging around, and that's the danger if you are the L.A. Lakers.
C.J. Miles gets inside. Lots of contact. They come the other way. Fisher inside. Artest buying them with the finish. And it's back to 10.
But more so than their resilience and them hanging around, I give credit to the Lakers. They allowed the Jazz to hang around by their lethargic play.
And Deron Williams is a big part, too. He has a terrific first half. Boozer gets up and under. Boozer now in double figures with 10. Game 2 will be Tuesday night back here at the Staples Center. And then Game 3 not until Saturday. Phil Jackson actually called this a very important game for the home team. And he doesn't say that very often, as let's listen to him at halftime.
This concept of mind, right? Concept of mind, I'll go back and attack. They shot a measly 40% or 65 and got away with it. They're still sitting in the ball game. Like they made free throws. We didn't shoot free throws so well. They made some critical plays, 3-point plays.
Well, buying him a big play. Let's just see him talking. Who's lurking behind? Great Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. That was not a picture. That was the real guy. Miles misses. Boozer tip with a left hand won't go. And Bynum comes away with it. Bynum started the game. Again with that small tear cartilage in his knee. Is Artest able to finish? We saw Bynum limping a bit in the first half. He played in that first half 13 minutes. And despite the injury out there for Phil Jackson.
Three straight layups, two dunks and a layup. That defense is just not getting it done. You've got to keep people out of the paint.
Miles draws the foul on Bynum. Good aggressive move from Miles.
And people will think I'm crazy, but pay attention to the details. The Phoenix Suns are a superior defensive team to the Utah Jazz. Clear.
Oh, I couldn't agree more. Hey, listen. The job the Phoenix Suns have done this year in improving their defense has gone a little bit unnoticed because they're still one of the most proficient offensive teams in the league. But I give credit to a buy-in by the Suns and to Alvin Gentry and his staff emphasizing it, repeating it, and a scheme that makes sense for their talent base.
And their series against San Antonio will start tomorrow night. Phoenix has the home court. Miles goes 1-for-2. Miles, who was signed to an offer sheet by Oklahoma City during the offseason, they really wanted him, but Utah matched it, a 4-year, $15 million deal, and a whistle and a foul. Again, part of that starting lineup for Utah with three second-round picks. He's one of them. And an undrafted rookie in Wes Matthews. Yet they still was able to get the fifth seed in the West and win a first-round playoff series without two key men in Okor and Kirilenko. Fisher spots up for three. Too strong. Here comes Matthews. Artest on Darren Williams. And a whistle and a foul on Ron Artest. You see Fasinko with that foul. Fasinko, the starting center, with Okur out. He was a second-round pick of Philadelphia back in 07. He didn't play, was traded to Utah, born in the Ukraine, played some pro ball in the Ukraine, and most of his first 2 years in the NBA in the D-League, very good in the D-League. Still getting his feet wet, so to speak, in the NBA. Williams' jump shot won't go. Kobe Bryant with his first five shots from the field. Nice pass inside to Bynum. And Fasinko fouls him. Two on the big man. Lakers will take it out. Artest to Gasol. Easy one. Boozer the rebound. Here's Matthews. Fasinko not looking to shoot. Pass deflected. Matthews on the drive. Gets inside. Nice move. Rookie now with 7 points. He's got one of those games where he doesn't do anything great. He just does everything really well.
He's a solid player. And when given the opportunity, and you don't get a lot of them, through injury, he was ready, he took advantage, and now he's going to be locked into Utah for quite a long time.
Bynum gets it to go. Nice left hand from Bynum. He's got 8 points. Miles. Pass. Fasinko throws it down. That's his first shot attempt.
And that offense is created by Darren Williams. So without calling a set play, he puts the ball on the floor, puts guys in position to make plays. Fasinko able to finish that.
And causes a timeout for Phil Jackson. His team unable to really shake Utah yet. The lead still 9 as the Jazz hanging tough.
See the ability of Darren Williams to dance, get into the seams, force white jerseys to help, and then he makes the play. So with his ability to make plays offensively with his size and his scoring ability, forces the issue and creates opportunities.
Back in Los Angeles, where the Lakers lead the Jazz 61-52, early third quarter of game one. Darren Williams doing his best to keep the Jazz in this game. They've trailed by as many as 14.
And he came back. 17 points, 5 assists, single-handedly keeping Utah in the game. And this is what makes him special as a pick-and-roll player. Occupies the defense, not only the two trying to guard the pick and roll, but Pau Gasol is late in his rotation. And then finally, throw it down, little man.
Darren Williams has become such a terrific player. He's born in West Virginia, grew up in a suburb of Dallas, was a huge Jason Kidd fan, and his mom a big influence. She played basketball at West Liberty State College. She coached him in grade school. And has always been a big part of what he's done as Bynum double team. Artest, that's a 2-pointer, and over the backboard.
You can certainly see the similarities between Darren Williams and Jason Kidd. I think the difference is his ability to score, where Jason Kidd became a spot-up shooter later on in his career. This guy is a legitimate scorer.
He's only 25, although he says he's 37 years old in Sloan years. Miles gets it to go. Nice move from C.J. Miles.
And in the highlight, you called him little man. I'd like to know if he's little man, what are you?
Well, I was just doing my Bill Walton reference since Luke Walton's on the team. I couldn't say big man. I should have had a Fasinko highlight when he dunked it. I like Fasinko. I know I'm not supposed to, but I like Fasinko.
Bryant, oh, tough shot. They defended it beautifully. He thought they hit him.
And I like that guy, too. Kobe Bryant competitive instincts since he came into this league.
Fisher called for the foul. Three on Fisher.
Well, just this is excellent defense by Wes Matthews. Could have been an offensive foul. Fasinko, great early help. Incredible contest. How do you make a shot? How do you get up that shot up to the basket?
He's 7 of 9 from the field. Jazz still within 9. We've played 5 minutes here in the third quarter. Williams to Boozer. Matthews for 3. Hooks it in. A 3-pointer for Wes Matthews. He's got 10. And it's a 6-point game. Crowd trying to urge the Lakers on a bit. They can't shake the Jazz. Gasol took a shot in the face inadvertent. They let him play. Bryant short that time. Bynum nearly tips it in. Boozer gets it. Here comes Williams. Miles open for 3. It's a 3-point game, 63-60. A 13-4 run for Utah.
I think that's going to be a big point. The 2s and 3s for the Jazz. Are they going to score enough to give them a chance? And certainly they have picked up their game.
They're the second best shooting team in the NBA in the regular season. First in the first round of the playoffs. Matthews. Derek Fisher, did he deflect it? They say yes. So it's Utah basketball, but missed opportunity there.
He was always one of the most difficult guys to score against when you had numbers, because he's not afraid to take a charge. He has good instincts about faking to try to give the ball handler a different look, good hands, and I think Deron Williams made a poor decision there, giving the ball up too early. Keep it in your hands. You make the decision.
Matthews partially blocked, but Boozer gets it. Kicks it back out to Williams. Jazz scrapping as they always do. Fasinko. Matthews for 3. Had a chance to tie it there, but the Jazz fighting back here in the third quarter as the Laker fans getting a bit anxious. Bryant, another all pass this time to Gasol. Looked like he was going to shoot it on the perfect feed.
Good adjustment. That's a good adjustment, realizing that the bigs for the Jazz are looking to contest this shot. That time, the unselfish, correct play, dropping it off to Gasol.
Matthews to Fasinko. Short. He's just so hesitant to shoot the ball.
Lakers looking strictly pick and roll with Bryant and Gasol, trusting that Bryant will make play.
Miles is on him now, and a reach in on Miles. That shot won't count. 14 foul, and 3rd on Miles.
This is good basketball by Bryant. Pick and roll or isolation is not a license to shoot the basketball. It's a license to make the right play. That time he drew 2 guys, and the ability to still have the vision to see the wide open target in the great hands of Gasol, catches and finishes.
And he does such a great job of keeping the ball high when he catches it. So he gives the defense no chance to close and block shots.
Bynum sits, Odom back in. Bynum, 8 points, 8 rebounds. Playing with that slight tear in the knee. Bryant behind the back. That's a 2, and Fisher nails it. Lakers back up by 7. Williams for 3. Short. Gasol, who had 18 rebounds in that game 6 victory against Oklahoma State, has 7 so far today. Fisher on the drive and a foul. The veteran Derek Fisher puts the Lakers back up by 9.
Utah was very slow getting back in transition, so they were cross-matched. Millsap closes out. Fisher with the blow-by and the finish. Again, late help. Everything's coming right around the basket area for L.A.
Fisher's missed a couple of free throws. He's normally an excellent free throw shooter. Matthews shut off by Artest. Like a brick wall. Boozer able to get it. 12 for Boozer.
Right now, it's exclusive. Kobe Bryant making plays off pick and rolls, isolation. He's making great reads off of this Jazz defense.
Artest, that's a three. It's going to be Utah ball. Artest has really struggled, to say the least. 6 of 34 from downtown. Amazing is being here. Season tickets for 2010, 2011 on sale now. Go to NBA tickets, NBA.com/tickets to reserve your seats. The NBA, where amazing happens. Williams banks it in, and it's back to 5 again. I mentioned those Artest three-point numbers. Those are in the playoffs, first round and so far here in game one. Boozer single coverage. And Gasol takes his time and lays it in.
Not much you can do. Great patience by Gasol, waiting until all the traffic got out of the way and then taking advantage of that size.
Boozer shuffle pass to Millsap. Good ball movement from Utah.
You're not going to see too many teams where bigs pass to bigs as well as in this series. LA's bigs do it very well, but Boozer, Millsap are better passers than people would think.
And Gasol. Both Boozer and Gasol, what makes them so effective, they're both in many ways ambidextrous on the floor. Williams drive. And he'll go to the free throw line. And we'll take a timeout. Another strong game for Pau Gasol.
Well, if you take away Pau Gasol's middle move, he's got a great counter back. This time he counters to the turnaround jump shot. And when he gets deeper, he'll go to his patented left-hand jump hook as his counter move. Here, Boozer's leaning on him, spins back, uses the left, uses the glass.
Back here for game one, Lakers lead the Jazz 73-66. Wes Matthews is one of the great stories for the Jazz. 4 years at Marquette. Wasn't drafted, though. Played the summer league. Signed as a free agent. He impressed a man that is not easily impressed.
I think it's just his nature to be a hard worker and try to do what he can to play on a team. And he's been terrific. You'd like to have 12 guys like him day to day to work with, because he's willing to do the extra work that it takes to make yourself better.
Take all 12 type of Wes Matthews. That's such a hard worker and has made himself into a player, as he's talking with Monty McCutcheon.
He's a modern-day Rocky. That's what he is. He's the underdog that made it. Those are great stories. He was a very effective college player, and even though he wasn't drafted, found his niche. If you defend hard and you have role acceptance and know who you are and you can make a spot-up shot, you can make a team. And that's what he did. Now he has an opportunity to start.
When he went to training camp, even Deron Williams was saying, he's like, who is this kid? We just impressed on how hard he played all the time. And he's one of those guys you almost need to see his body of work. He's not going to just blow you away right away, but you see him over time and you appreciate what he brings.
And there's going to be somebody in this year's draft that's going to be put in a situation where they're going to thank Wesley Matthews because of his work ethic, because of what he's done for this Jazz team. Teams are going to be looking for the next Wesley Matthews.
Bryant, couple of fakes. Matthews defends it well. Bryant still puts it in. His ability to knock down shots with a hand right in his face.
I'll tell you what else is going to happen in this draft. They're going to be looking for somebody like Kobe Bryant.
Forget about it.
Boozer against Gasol. Tough shot from Boozer over the outstretched arm of Pau Gasol. Odom running the show out there. Gasol down the other end. Artest tips it. Odom grabbed Millsap by the neck to not let him go. It's still Utah ball.
You look at this shot by Carlos Boozer, almost as impressive as Bryant's shot over the contested hands. That's a fadeaway jump shot over the contested hand of a 7-footer.
Over the fingertips. Matthews inside. Can't get it to go. Tip by Millsap won't go. 6-point Laker lead as we wind down the third quarter. And a foul on Korver before the shot. Second on Korver. They're in the penalty. Lakers have only taken 9 free throw attempts so far in the game.
And Utah usually fouls excessively.
And they're amongst the leaders. Kobe Bryant normally gets to the line, although not a lot in Oklahoma City series. He has not been to the line this afternoon. TNT on Monday. Second round games, Boston and Cleveland game 2. San Antonio and Phoenix still start game 1. ESPN on Friday. Cleveland and Boston game 3. Phoenix and San Antonio game 3. And then ABC next Saturday. The Lakers and Jazz from Salt Lake City. A primetime game on ABC. And the Jazz steal one of the first 2 here in the Staples Center. Most felt this was the one that had the best chance. After the Lakers playing that emotional game on Friday night in Oklahoma City to eliminate the Thunder. Williams the drive. Korver fakes. Crowd wanted to travel. Millsap tied up. Boozer on the drive. Blocked from behind. Great Laker defense. And 4 left to shoot. Laker defense was so good in the Oklahoma City series. Korver gets it to go. Korver off the bench with 5 points. Final minute, third quarter. Largest lead was 14 for the Lakers. That was in the first half. They've led by as many as 12 here in the third. Bryant, an easy bucket.
That's just too easy offensively. You understand that that's Laker offense. You got to do a better job of defending that play.
Williams drives on Brown and gets the banker. 22 for Deron Williams.
And good use of the clock. Let the ball roll to half court and then attack to get the 2-for-1.
Brown falls. Jazz wanted to travel. Korver tripped him up, says Monty McCutcheon. And more free throws. 3 fouls. Well, they call it on Boozer. That's his 3rd. Nobody with 4 fouls in this game. A host of players with 3.
And how important is it going forward for the Utah Jazz to be able to sign Carlos Boozer? With Mehmet Okur injured, 31 years old, you have no idea how that Achilles is going to react. If they can't sign him and he goes elsewhere, they have no low post offensive players.
So surprising in many ways that he's still on the team. Last summer, he was had the opportunity to opt out of his contract, and it said he was going to do that, decided not to, came back, was a subject of trade rumors before the trading deadline because he's unrestricted. Kevin O'Connor would love to re-sign him, and now there's talk that, you know, he just might stay. He's worked so well with Deron Williams. There's about a 3.5-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Shannon Brown, good size on Deron Williams. Williams the drive. Can't get it to go. Odom the rebound. Lakers have plenty of time. Shannon Brown gets hit. Matthews with the foul. When you talk about a turnaround here, you have a chance to cut it to 5. Now the other way, Lakers have a chance to increase it to 9. Three on Matthews. As Boozer sits. Shannon Brown, who last year in the playoffs had some big moments in the conference finals against Denver. He's got great size at 6'4", strong. Now his 4th year in the NBA, 2nd with L.A., the former Cleveland draft pick out of Michigan State. He's played for 4 different teams, but they like him here now. He just has so much ability. He's the perfect defender for Williams. So as the quarter comes to an end.
Oh, he almost put it in. That's a heck of an attempt.
As the third quarter comes to an end, it ends the same way halftime end with an 8-point lead for the Lakers. Williams and Boozer leading the way as usual for the Utah Jazz. Pau Gasol having another terrific game as the Lakers continue to shoot well. 60% from the field. But the Jazz hanging tough. We head to the fourth quarter. Lakers 81, Jazz 73. This presentation of the NBA playoffs on ABC continues after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Welcome back to Los Angeles with Bill Jackson. You shot a terrific percentage. What has allowed the Jazz to be so close in this one?
I think they were very aggressive offensively, driving the ball to the basket. That's starting the third quarter. Set up some easy baskets, some three-point shots.
You've made no secret of the fact that this is an important one to win. How do you guys make sure that happens?
We just have to take care of the inside, the interior part. Get the ball into our big guys.
Bill, thank you. Mike.
Well, Doris, they rarely lose at home when they have the lead after three quarters. 32-1 at home when leading after three this season. The only one was Portland. And that was late in the season as a foul away from the ball. They know how to wrap it up. You know, the Jazz trying to come back from that 14-point deficit in their best shooting quarter of the game. That foul on Walton, his second.
To me, this is going to be very interesting for Utah. How are they going to create offense?
Again, you look at this lineup. Kostakoufos is out there. Millsap, Ronnie Price, Kyle Korver, and C.J. Miles. Ball stripped by Shannon Brown.
And the answer to that question is they're not going to create offense. This is a team offensively that's challenged right now on the floor. The only way to do that is getting it done defensively and getting some easy baskets.
Price calls it out. Ronnie Price, point guard out of Utah Valley University. Millsap. And it's a six-point game again. Millsap off the bench with 10 points, 7 rebounds. Farmar. Not many starters out there for either team right now. In fact, Bynum's the only starter out there. Shot clock at 4. Shannon Brown's going to have to put it up. Good boxing out from Millsap, who had a 24-rebound game this season during the regular season. As we mentioned, had a 19-rebound game in the Denver series. They list him as 6'8". There's no way he's 6'8". C.J. Miles jump shot. Short. Price had it, lost it, scrambles. Bowden dives on top of it, and they call a foul. You rarely see that call when the ball is on the floor. We say it all the time. Guys can jump on each other. It doesn't matter. Mike Callahan, I think, had the right call there.
That was the right call because Price protected the basketball with his body, forcing Lamar Odom to basically climb on top of him in order to try to get the basketball. That's the correct call.
I still think you should be able to do anything you want to a guy on the floor.
That's one of your rule proposals, right?
Right. Anything goes.
Price kicks it out to Korver. Korver, that's a 2. Too strong, and Odom the rebound. Outlet to Walton. Hacked by Korver. And Korver does a good job making shot. He doesn't get off a shot as he picks up his third.
I think I would like to see a race between Kyle Korver and Luke Walton. That could have been the slowest two guys running down the floor in a transition opportunity.
I'm not going to make any jokes about slow guys. I'm not in position to make jokes about speed.
That's a good point, but either am I. But I'm just saying, I love Luke Walton's passing, and I love Kyle Korver's shooting. I'm not a fan of their speed in transition.
I love the way that Luke Walton looked like a receiver. Saw the ball into his chest, and then put himself in position to draw the contact. Didn't wait for it, went and got it. Almost like Wes Welker.
Odom with another rebound off the missed free throw. Farmar. And a reset. Walton did not play a lot in the regular season. That pinched nerve kept him out a good portion of it. Phil Jackson loves him in that second unit. This is the stuff you were talking about, Jeff, not the speed.
Right, very high basketball IQ. Can play the 3 or the 4, but he can really pass the basketball.
The Price for 3. In and out. And Bynum grabs another rebound. 9 boards for Bynum. 7-point game. 2.5 gone by here in the fourth. Game 1 of this Western Conference semifinals. Both teams coming off victories Friday night. Brown can't hit. And Millsap another board.
It's 21 in this quarter, Utah's winning. Both teams don't have a lot of guys who can make or create their own shot out there.
Nice move from Millsap.
Paul Millsap, who also had an offer sheet this past summer. Portland gave him a lot of money, 4 years, $32 million. But because of the uncertainty of Boozer, Utah had to match it. Plus, they love how the kid plays. And he's undersized almost every night in battles. Bynum can't finish. Rufus with the rebound. Here comes Price. Price to the basket. Banks it in. And it's a three-point game. This is the closest it's been since the first quarter.
We talked about this unit. Create offense by getting stops and pushing the basketball. They certainly have done that.
Bynum looking to post up. Short again. Ronnie Price rips down the rebound. The smallest guy on the floor. And the Jazz bench getting it done right now against the Laker bench. Millsap wants it. Spins inside. Layup won't go. Shannon Brown may have hurt himself on that last play. He's holding on to his left side as he comes up the floor. Four minutes gone by in the fourth. Odom lost it. Look at Price, scrappy, hustling.
That's the second time he's doubled the post and created something good.
Inside the Millsap, one-point game with 7:40 remaining. The Jazz keep fighting, and their all-stars are on the bench while this comeback occurs here in the fourth. Timeout, Lakers. Actually heard a smattering of boos there here at the Staples Center. Ronnie Price and a bunch of reserves for the Utah Jazz on an 8-1 run here in the fourth.
These guys have come into the basketball game and given themselves a chance. You talk about Ronnie Price, well, the price is right. And then once again, the bigs for the Jazz. Millsap putting himself in position by running the floor. Outstanding job. And the bench enjoying the impact that they've had.
As the Lakers, once up by 14, they lead by just a point on Verizon Wireless Game Track. And you see the fourth quarter. Williams and Boozer sitting during this surge by the Jazz. Bryant and Gasol have been as well. Bryant's back in, as is Gasol. Boozer back in, but Williams stays on the bench. Odom jump shot, short. And the Jazz with a chance to take their first lead since the opening minutes. On the drive, draws the contact, he'll go to the free throw line.
And Miles turned the corner earlier in the game off the pick and roll, coming off to his strong left hand. He has an ability to run a pick and roll, and sometimes you need that second guy other than Deron Williams to be able to execute. Here he rejects the screen, drives into traffic, and draws the contact.
And Phil Jackson got away with it in game six, leaving Bryant and Gasol on the bench for a long period of time. The tough thing about it, once again doing it today, you're forcing these guys to win the game twice because they had a cushion, the bench didn't show up, and now all of a sudden, we have ourselves a brand new game.
The Jazz with the lead. First time since it was 10-8, they've come back from 14 down in the first half, from 12 down in the third quarter, and they've done it with their all-star point guard on the bench right now, getting a nice long rest. 10-1 is the score here in the fourth quarter as Korver is called for a blocking foul.
Coach, you gotta love what Ronnie Price is doing. He's double teaming the ball hard and then sprinting back to the body of his man. Multiple effort plays, and that's how you get it done defensively.
Absolutely. He's already caused two turnovers in the post, one on Bynum and one on Lamar Odom. Right there, as you said, doubled the post, made Kyle Gasol kick it out. He's got good quickness and good toughness.
Another one of those undrafted players. 4 years at Utah Valley as Odom gets it. Bryant sets up for three. In and out. And Price skies for the rebound. Price played in college. It wasn't until his senior year that they went Division I, but he was a big-time scorer, third in the nation. Didn't get drafted and has worked his way here to Utah. His Millsap shot won't go. Boozer's tip, the second effort. And the Jazz lead by three. What a turnaround for Utah. And the Staples Center very, very quiet all of a sudden. Darren Williams just gets off the bench, and a foul on the entry pass.
And this is such a tough decision as a coach. You have a unit who is rolling, but you have your best player sitting on the bench. When do you bring him back, or do you let the bench just continue on? I think Jerry Sloan makes the right move in bringing Darren Williams back.
What a superb job by Price. 10 minutes, 2 points, three assists, three rebounds, ran the show. Good defense. Our test. Spin move results in a miss, but Odom another rebound. Odom fires a three. Won't go. Gasol the rebound. Fisher right back to Gasol. Blocked by Boozer. Counted and a foul. Second shot opportunities. Pau Gasol with a big offensive board. And the Lakers with a chance to tie it on this free throw. Timeout with 5:59 remaining in the fourth.
Good job of chasing down the loose rebound, keeping the ball alive. Gasol outlet, and then Fisher not settling. Gets it right back to the hands of Gasol, knocks down the basket, takes the contact, going to the line for the possible three-point play.
Thanks for watching ESPN on ABC, home of the NBA Finals.
Jordy Luis Dreyfus on hand at the Staples Center for game one of this Western Conference semifinal. Red Hot Chili Peppers well represented. Anthony Kiedis and Flea. Now we saw Kareem in the locker room earlier. Great Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Pele, Kobe, LeBron. Do you want it to be Flea? That's like a gnat.
We'll have to find the origin of why he calls himself that as Gasol ties the game.
22 points, 8 rebounds, 4 assists, and 4 block shots for Pau Gasol. Game tied at 85. Just past the midway point of the fourth. Boozer shuffles it out. Nice fake. Millsap drives left-handed, banks it in. Millsap having a terrific game off the bench.
That's a good job not settling for the foul line jump shot. Put the ball on the floor, kept the pressure on this Laker defense.
That's his third shot that has been a left-handed finish today.
Korver reach-in foul. And they're in the penalty. Korver picks up his fifth.
And that's a bad foul by Korver, but this is a good play by Millsap. Showing the shot, Kobe Bryant gets out of the way, and Millsap wards off the defense and finishes with his left hand.
This is the first free throw attempt of the afternoon for Kobe Bryant. Had that hot start to the game. Had 10 points in the first quarter, hit his first 5 shots. As Wesley Matthews back in.
Now you made a great point earlier, Coach, when you talked about the tough decisions of a coach, whether to put back in a guy for a guy that's rolling. I think it's an easier decision to make when it's your best player. Then it's a no-brainer. When it's your best player who's playing well in his own right, he's the guy that gives you the best chance to win this ball game. The correct move by Jerry Sloan put Darren Williams back in the game.
The Lakers' best player hits a pair of free throws. Drive by, and oh boy, he go down hard. Wow. Could not cushion it at all with his arms. You could hear the thud. And Miles shaking up on the foul. Wow. He sits up. Gary Briggs once again on the floor attending to him. We'll be right back. All new ABC Wednesday at 10, 9 Central. It's the marvelous and the mysterious rolled into one. Welcome to ABC's Happy Town. Don't let the name fool you. ABC's Happy Town, all new Wednesday at 10, 9 Central on ABC. And great to see C.J. Miles walks to the free throw line. And a smile on his face. He got up and then goes and knocks down the free throw. We said Miles has become an important every year. Gets a little more playing time with this Jazz team. He's still so young. As we said, went from high school to the NBA, only 23. He was less than 2 years old when Jerry Sloan was named head coach of the Jazz. In fact, there are 15 players in the NBA this year who weren't even born when Sloan was named head coach of the Jazz. 5 minutes left, 2-point Utah lead. Bryant the drive, left-handed. Odom right there to clean it up. Odom hasn't scored a lot in the playoffs, but he's picked his spots very well. Miles another drive, left-hander, knocks it down. Tough shot from C.J. Miles. And he now has 14 points. Gasol double, Matthews with the steal. 3-on-2, Matthews, Williams. Right back to Matthews, Odom pokes it away. The rookie gets it back. Millsap to Matthews, reverse layup, banks it in. Wesley Matthews again, and the lead is 4. This ties the largest lead of the game for the Jazz. Bryant spinning, gets inside, draws the foul, and he'll shoot 2.
Now, this is a perfect example of why you knock teams out when you have an opportunity, because you allow them to hang around. There's a price to pay late on in the ballgame. Give the Jazz a lot of credit for hanging in, giving themselves a chance, and then great energy off the bench.
And that's a really good basketball play when you throw it into the low post to cut baseline. Artest got a layup earlier in the game like that. Wesley Matthews did. Throw it in. Oftentimes, your defender looks away, beat him to the basket, good give and go.
You see the reserves with Miles, 16, Millsap, 16. Millsap also with 9 rebounds. And Matthews in double figures. Bryant hits a pair. 22 for Kobe Bryant.
We gave the Lakers defense a lot of credit earlier. They're going to have to find a way to knuckle down and get some stops to close out this game.
Their defense has been the key in the first series. Millsap tied up by Gasol. Williams looking. Miles, shot clock down to 3. Miles left-handed again. Ball tipped and taken by Gasol.
Great defensive sequence by the Lakers.
Crowd getting on its feet. They've been quiet here in the fourth quarter. Bryant puts it up, it's good, and a foul. Chance for a 3-point play as the game tied with 3:16 remaining.
What you don't want to do if you're defending Bryant is let him off the hook. Force him to make a play and score over you. Miles does not get the offensive foul, gives Bryant a wide open look, able to knock down the shot and get the contact. Live with the results when you play outstanding defense.
And I like the switch that Jerry Sloan is calling for, putting the stronger Wesley Matthews on Bryant versus keeping Miles on.
Lakers back up by 1. Kobe Bryant coming alive here in the fourth quarter.
And to me, if you're Utah going down the stretch defensively, you've got to make Ron Artest be the shooter.
Millsap steps back. Shot won't go. Pau Gasol with his 10th rebound. Under 3 to play. Lakers trying to get game 1.
Bryant not wanting to pick and roll. He wants to play isolation.
Artest straight on. 3-pointer off the mark. Matthews with the rebound.
I like that defense. No rotation to Artest. Stun at him. You got to play the numbers.
Williams nearly lost the ball. Fisher banging him. Good aggressive defense from Fisher.
I like what Fisher's doing.
Williams to the basket. And ball knock goes picked up by Artest. Jazz wanted a foul. Here's Fisher drives. Offensive foul. Terrific defensive play from C.J. Miles. Steps in and draws the hard charge. He's hurting. And hobbling. That's what you expect from a Jerry Sloan coach team.
Well, it's playoff basketball. Good job by Miles. Derek Fisher, one of the best in the business, is doing exactly this. Well, Miles steps in, takes the charge, and Jerry Sloan saying, that's how I used to do it when I played for the Bulls.
That's a pretty good impression. Sunday and Monday. The Santa Monica Pier, not too far from where Carlos Boozer and the Jazz trying to come up with the upset. Terrific shooting in the second half. Much better defense. One of the reasons they're only down by one.
And you look, first half, the shot blocking by the Lakers impacted the shooting percentage by the Jazz. Two blocks on this possession. Now you look at a drive by Millsap. Look how he uses his body to ward off Gasol. Keeps the ball away from the shot blocker. Good use of the left hand. And then again, C.J. Miles takes it right at Odom's body. Creates a little space. A little left-handed floater. Good offense individually by the Jazz.
Williams brings it up with Wesley Matthews, Boozer, Paul Millsap, and C.J. Miles on the floor for the Jazz. Trying to get a road win here in game one. Boozer the drive inside, blocked by Odom. Lamar Odom, another big fourth quarter play. Gasol double team, inside pass, nearly tipped in by Millsap, knocked away. Williams looking, Fisher battling. Miles for three. Too strong, and Bryant gets the long rebound. Minute and a half remaining. Bryant has 25 in the game. Matthews right up on him. Bryant, pull-up jumper, puts it in. Lakers by three.
That's called fundamentals. Good old-fashioned isolation basketball.
9 points in the fourth quarter for Kobe Bryant. Darren Williams goes right at Gasol, and a foul call. So aggressive and so strong going to the rack. Five fouls on Odom.
Good job by Darren Williams, taking it to the body of the bigs. Certainly some contact by Odom, attempting to block shot. How about on the other end? Mama, there goes that man. One-on-one, allow me to have this dance. That's good defense, but better offense by Bryant.
Williams has shot more free throws in the playoffs than anybody so far through the first round. Gets that one to go. It's his first points of the fourth quarter. He's 7 of 9 from the line.
And here's where the suspense is taken out of the game of basketball. Everybody knows very well what's going to happen on the offensive end for the Lakers. The ball is going to be in the hands of Bryant. It's up to the Jazz, if I was them, to get the ball out of his hands and live with somebody else making the play.
And to me, again, it's Ron Artest has to be the guy that ends up shooting the perimeter shot, because you don't want it going inside to Odom and Gasol.
Bryant calling for it. Millsap leaning toward the help. Bryant looks up at the shot clock as we get under a minute remaining. Backs in, falling away. Won't go. Boozer comes flying in. Lost it to Odom. Odom puts it in. Lamar Odom coming up huge here in the fourth quarter.
Big time play by Odom. Getting it done on both boards.
Williams to Boozer. Fisher picks up the loose ball. Jazz certainly don't have to foul yet. Still plenty of time. 3-point Laker lead.
I think if you're Bryant, you have to realize how you're being defended by Matthews and force the issue. Too much contact.
Bryant to the basket, lays it up and in. Lakers by 5. Timeout, Utah.
Great defensive sequence by Wes Matthews. Forces the miss. Just too long and too good. Odom finishes. And then Kobe Bryant, late help. No shot blocking at the rim. Lakers, 11-2 run, up 5.
ESPN, LosAngeles.com. 22.6 seconds remaining. There you see Utah still with one timeout. Lakers do not have a foul to give. They have multiple timeouts as the Jazz now trail by five. Lakers were down by four with just under 4 minutes to go. And this 11-2 run that you spoke of, Jeff.
And I'm going for the three right here.
Williams the drive inside. Boozer throws it down. And it's a three-point game. They have to foul. And Kobe Bryant is the one they foul.
See, you have to foul, but I'm going to double-team Bryant there and have the ball go back to Lamar Odom and then take my chances. I think when you get the ball in a great free throw shooter's hands, even though Bryant has not shot free throws great in this playoff, that you a second or two difference is worth getting the ball in a lesser free throw shooter's hands.
He's 5 for 5 today. He's got 11 points in the last 5 minutes. And that makes it a two-possession game with 19 seconds remaining.
You know, people will fall in love and say Kobe Bryant took over this basketball game. He certainly did. But do not underestimate the impact that Lamar Odom has had in this fourth quarter. Outstanding job on both ends of the floor. He had every right to claim this victory also.
Two clutch free throws from Bryant. Five-point game. Jazz have just one timeout left. Darren Williams fires up the three. Won't go. Rebound inside. Layup blocked by Gasol. The rebound and a foul. Fifth block of the game for Pau Gasol. And the Lakers on the verge of taking game one. Darren Williams trying to plead a foul call.
Same old song. Limp. Athleticism. Contest. Great job by Gasol. Blocking the shot, keeping the ball alive, and then pursuing the basketball.
Lakers blew a 14-point lead with a terrible start to the fourth quarter. As Gasol will put on the finishing touches. Jazz with a terrific comeback, but they couldn't hold on to a 4-point lead with under four to play. Another superb game for Gasol. Now 25 points, 12 rebounds, 4 assists, 5 block shots. Matthews on the drive, goes inside, and a silly foul by Gasol. But it's a 7-point game with 5.3 remaining. And this one is over. Matthews will shoot. Phil Jackson's team bounces back. He's a little concerned coming in after the emotional game on Friday night against Oklahoma City. And those playing a Jazz team that fights right down to the bitter end. Wesley Matthews. Strong game for Utah, but it won't be enough. Jackson wins game one. His team goes on and wins. There's Bryant, and that'll do it. Lakers take game one. Here at the Staples Center and finish with a 15-6 run in the final 4 minutes. Kobe Bryant finishes with 31 points. The final score, Lakers 104, the Jazz 99. For Mark Jackson, Jeff Van Gundy, Doris Burke, and our entire terrific ABC crew, this is Mike Green saying so long from L.A. Make sure to tune in tomorrow at 8, 7 Central for an all-new episode of Dancing with the Stars. Now, except on the West Coast, ABC's World News or your local news. Thanks for watching ABC, home of the NBA Finals.